Well, praise the Lord, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us today. We are excited that you have tuned in and excited about what Jesus is going to do. We have an awesome service plan for you guys, so we're so excited. So here's what I want you to do. We're going to sing a really, really super duper awesomely fun action song. So what you need to do is stand up. Come on, over. Yep. Even you sitting right there. Come on, don't be lazy. You got to stand up. Now, here's what I need you to do. I want you to take your wings and spread them out just like this. And one time you're going to spin just like that. But don't get Disney because you'll fall over. So now, when you did that, did you hit somebody? Because if you did, you're standing too close. Now tell them, get out of my space. This is my space. You got to have room to worship Jesus. So try it again. Hold out your wings. Spin around. Boom, 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 boom. Ah, boom. Good job. Now, that is your worship room. Don't let anybody in it. Now you can put your hands down. And the next thing you're going to do is we're going to sing a really fun song. So to get this song to start, you got to yell really, really loud. Hit it, maestro! Can you do that? Let me hear you. Hit it, maestro! Good job! Now our song is going to start right now.
To the King of Kings, making melody in my heart, making melody in my heart, making melody in my heart, and to the King of Kings. Now
Thompson,
making melody in my heart, making melody in my heart, making melody in my heart, and to the King.
Thumbs in,
elbows out, making melody in my heart, making melody in my heart, making melody in my heart, to the King of Kings. Thumbs in,
elbows out,
knees bent, making melody in my heart, making melody.
Thumbs in,
elbows out,
knees bent,
feet apart, making melody in my heart.
Elbows out.
Knees bent.
Feet apart.
Turn around.
Making melody in my heart. Making melody in my heart. To the King of Kings. So thumbs in.
Elbows out.
Knees bent.
Feet apart.
Turn around.
Thumbs out.
Who's having a great time in Jesus' house? Oh man, the Bible tells us to let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Whew, and I'm out of breath right now. So, you know what? How many of you brought a friend with you to church today? Anybody bring a friend? Yeah, we should always invite our friends to church. So, I've got a friend with me, and I want you to meet her. She's really, really awesome. Who wants to meet my friend? Just raise your hand. Raise it. There you go. Awesome. So, let me go get her, and I'm going to bring her out here. And let me tell you a little bit about her. She lives right here in this bag. She lives in this pink backpack. And if you've ever seen us in service, you know her name. Yell it out really loud. Who knows her name? Yell it. Oh, yeah, that's right.
Her name is Cindy Jordan. But what name does she like to go by? Does anybody know that? Right, yeah. She likes for us to call her CJ. But let me see what she's been doing ever since the last time you've seen her. See what she's been up to. And so I'm going to get her out here. Now, I have to remind you, you remember, boys? It's a girl. Yeah, and we know how girls are, right? They have attitude. No, I'm just kidding. I didn't say bad attitude. Maybe she's got a good attitude today, you think? I don't know. Let's find out if she's got a good attitude. So let me get her out here, and we're going to find out what she's been up to. Hey, Cindy? Cindy, where are you at? Are you in there? Cindy, what are you doing? Come here right now. I need you right... No, are you coming out?
No, I'm not going to come out.
What? What do you mean you're not coming out?
I heard what you said, and I'm not coming out.
Cindy, now is not the time. I need you to come out here right now.
No, I'm not going to do it because you was talking about girls.
I was just joking. Listen, Cindy, I already made a promise. I promised everybody you were going to come out.
Well, take it back.
No, I can't do that. All these girls and all these boys are waiting for you to...
Did you say boys?
I did.
Oh, man. And the boys are here just to see me?
Actually, no, they're not here just to see you. They're here because they want to worship Jesus.
No, I think they're here just to see me.
Nope, I don't think so. Let me put this on the ground because... Now... Here we go.
Oh, man. Hi, guys.
No, quit. You know what, Cindy? There's also girls here. And you need to be talking to the girls, too. You need to be telling them hi.
Oh, I'm going to tell the girls something, okay?
You are?
Yeah, I have something really important I want to tell the girls.
Okay, and what is that?
Stay away from my boys.
What?
Yeah, that's right. They're my guys. You stay away from them.
No, Cindy. They're not your guys. Listen, we came here today because we want to worship Jesus. Okay? Is that good, Cindy?
CJ.
What?
My name is CJ. Do you know how to spell?
I do know how to spell.
Okay, well, my name is CJ.
Oh, so you want us to call you CJ?
No, I want the boys to call me honey.
That's not going to happen. Don't do it. Do not call her honey.
How about baby? They can call me baby.
No, they're not going to call you baby. Listen, the reason that you're here is because all of these awesome boys and girls that are watching want to hear you sing a song.
Oh, right. Yeah, I can do that. I've been working on a really cool song just for the guys.
No. This is not for the guys. This is for Jesus. We're going to sing a song for Jesus. Are you ready?
No, I'm ready to sing to the guys. You are my sunshine.
Cindy.
What? You're messing me up.
No, you're messing up. We're not supposed to be singing to the guys. Listen, we're singing to Jesus.
No, I'm singing to the guys. My only sunshine, you make me happy.
No, stop. Listen, we're going to sing a song, and all of these boys and girls
love me.
No. Quit interrupting me. Listen, we're going to sing a song, and all of these boys and girls are going to sing with you. Now, all of you guys, all you have to do is say this. Say, ba, 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 ba. Say it really loud. Ba, 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 ba. Awesome. Good job. So
you're going to make them sound like a goat.
No. They're not going to sound like goat. They're going to sound like a sheep because the Bible tells us the Lord is our shepherd. And if he's the shepherd, then we're the sheep. And so they're going to sound like sheep. So everybody do that. Say, ba.
Wow, you sound like a sheep, all right.
I know. So anyway, are you ready?
Yeah, so I'm going to sing.
Yep, you're going to sing, and they're going to do the bad, 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 bass.
Yeah, I think this is going to be bad, 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 bad.
No, it's going to be good. It's going to really work. You're going to love this. So, are you ready? You're eating your hair.
It tastes good.
Well, quit eating it. So, all right, here we go. You ready? Here we go. We're going to sing a song, and don't forget your part. Bad, 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 bad. Are you ready? Let me hear you say it again. Good! You guys are awesome. All right. Here we go.
I just wanna be a sheep.
Bad, 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 bad.
I just wanna be a sheep.
Bad, 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 bad.
I pray to the Lord, nice old turkey. I just wanna be a sheep.
Bad, 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 bad.
I just wanna be a sheep.
Bad, 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 bad.
I just wanna be a sheep.
Bad, 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 bad.
I pray to the Lord, nice old turkey. I just wanna be a sheep.
Bad, 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 bad.
And I don't wanna be a Canaanite. I don't wanna be a Canaanite. 'Cause they always raise Canaanite. I just wanna be a sheep.
Bad, 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 bad.
I just wanna be a sheep.
Bad, 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 bad.
I pray to the Lord, nice old turkey. I just wanna be a sheep.
Bad, 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 bad. Good job!
Wait, 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 stop, 'cause I'm not done.
What?
I'm not finished. I have another verse.
Oh, you have another verse?
Yeah, I gotta sing another verse because they're loving this. Right, guys? You love this?
Oh, okay, so we're gonna sing another verse. You ready? What is it this time?
You just have to wait and see.
Oh, okay, here we go. Are you ready?
I don't wanna be a Pharisee. I don't wanna be a Pharisee. Because they're not fair, you see. I just wanna be a sheep.
Bad, 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 bad.
I just wanna be a sheep.
Bad, 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 bad.
I pray to the Lord, nice old turkey. I just wanna be a sheep.
Bad, 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 bad. Now I'm all out of breath.
That's okay, because we're not done. I'm gonna sing another verse.
No, no, no. You've already said you don't wanna be a Pharisee. That's enough, right?
No, I gotta sing another verse.
Okay, but this is it. No more verses after this.
I don't wanna be a Sadducee. I don't wanna be a Sadducee.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I got this.
Okay.
I just wanna be a sheep.
Bad, 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 bad.
I just wanna be a sheep.
Bad, 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 bad.
I pray to the Lord, nice old turkey. I just wanna be a sheep.
Bad, 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 bad. Awesome. Good job, guys. Let me get your backpack.
No, wait, wait, wait. What are you doing?
What? You got to go back into your suitcase. You got to go home, right?
No, I don't want to go yet.
Yes, you do. You have to go back in.
No, wait. I don't want to go. Stop, stop, stop.
What is wrong?
I didn't get to rap.
What?
They didn't get to hear me rap.
Because you don't know how to rap.
Yeah, I do. I can rap really, really good.
No, not right now. Now is not the time.
Wait, tell him you want to hear me rap. I want to hear you really loud.
No, don't stop. No, stop yelling. No, no, no. I don't.
See, I told you they want to hear me rap.
Okay, so how does this work?
I ain't going to rap.
Yeah, that's what you keep saying.
And you're going to hit the beat.
What?
Hit the beat. Beatbox. You know how to beatbox?
No, I don't know how to beatbox.
Yeah, all you gotta do is say, boots and cats and boots and cats and boots and cats and boots and cats and...
No, 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 that's not gonna work yet.
Yeah, you do that. You do that, and I'm gonna rap.
Okay, so who starts?
You start.
Oh, you want me to go first?
Yeah, hit the beat.
Okay. Sorry, guys, this is not gonna be good. Because how is this gonna work?
Well, I'm gonna rap.
Uh-huh.
And you're gonna hit the beat.
At the same time.
Oh, yeah, you're not that good, are you?
No, I'm not that good. So, okay, let's just get this over with. Are you ready? Here we go.
I just want to be a sheep. I just want to be a sheep. Don't want to be a Canaanite. I've ever seen a Sadducee. I just want to be a sheep. Ah, oh, man, you really did mess that up, didn't you?
Yeah, so I think it's time for you to go.
No, wait, I'm not leaving.
Yes, you are, so get out of here.
What? You're wrinkling my dress.
No, just get in. I'm not wrinkling your dress.
You're messing up my hair. Look at my hair now.
No, just get in.
Wait, no, I don't want to get...
No, Cindy, you gotta go. You need to go.
Help!
I was just thinking, why did I get a girl puppet?
I heard that.
Well, that's okay. See if you feel this.
Ow!
Awesome! You having a good time? Great. Now it's time for something super de-duper awesome, and you're gonna love this. Are you ready? All right, here we go.
Oh, hey! I didn't know you guys were there. We're so glad to see you today. We're gonna have a good time in Jesus. Haven't we already had a good time? Wow, wasn't that just awesome? I'm so excited to be here today.
excuse me.
Yes, Lord?
No, it's me. I'm looking for someone called Sunflower.
Is that you, Lord?
No, up here. Yes, ma'am.
Hello, sir. How are you doing?
I'm looking for someone named Sunflower.
That's me.
Finally, I've been looking everywhere for you. Sunflower.
Yes.
I've seen your name on the road, but I haven't seen you, and I wanted to make sure that you were truly here.
I'm so excited my name's on the row. I'm going to be there.
Sunflower.
Yes.
We're not talking about that row. We're talking about the church roll. You gotta log in. You gotta check in when you get here. You gotta make sure that we know that you are reporting for duty.
I'm reporting for duty.
Thank you.
Now, what kind of duty is that?
Well, I'm Faith Man, and we have to make sure that everyone knows their job. My job is to make sure that everybody has faith.
Oh, I'm so glad, because we need faith in today's time.
Sunflower.
Yes.
Do you know your role? She don't know her role.
No, sir.
You need to know your duty. If you're going to work for the kingdom of God, you need to know what your place is. I have faith.
What's my place? Do you know? Because I forgot.
Sunflower?
Yes, Faith Man.
Are you losing control?
Yes.
Now listen. I see that you have somebody else here.
Okay.
Yep, I was backstage and I heard somebody singing.
Oh, yeah, CJ.
Wait, what?
Yeah, CJ's her name. Didn't she do a great job?
That voice was angelic. I should meet this CJ.
Why do you want to meet CJ?
Well, how could she deny me? Look at this awesome body. I'm so awesome. I'm beautiful, right? I'm handsome. Yeah, I'm a really cool dude.
I don't think you guys would go good together.
Oh, no, I think we would go good together. Look at this. How can she resist this?
Well,
I need to meet CJ.
Now that I think about it,
yeah,
you two probably would make a good couple because she sounds just like
yes, indeed. I want to meet CJ. Such an angel.
Now who's losing focus? It's you.
Nope, I'm doing my job. I have faith, Sunflower, that I'm going to meet CJ. I have faith.
No.
I'm going to do it. I'm going to meet her. I'm going to meet CJ.
No, Faith Man.
What?
I remember my role.
What?
My role was to introduce you.
Me?
Yes, because you're supposed to be telling the kids what is faith.
Faith.
We're losing focus.
Faith means I get to see things that I don't usually get to see.
What do you mean?
CJ. I mean CJ. I want to see CJ.
What does the Bible say about faith? Let's go that direction.
The Bible says that faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen.
There it is. Did you hear that part of the verse?
Yeah, all right.
The evidence of things not seen. Guess what?
You don't get to see CJ. I haven't seen her. Where's she at?
I have faith. No, it's the evidence of things not seen.
But I want to see her.
No, that's not what the Bible says. The Bible says the evidence of things not seen. So you don't get to see her.
This is totally not fair, Sunflower.
Well, that's the Bible, buddy.
Well, I need to see CJ Postcase. I need to see her. I need to make sure she knows I'm here.
Well, you know what? I'll introduce you guys later.
Okay.
But right now.
Yep.
We need to get ready for the next part of the service. It's going to be so
exciting! What's going to happen now? What's going to happen?
I don't want to tell the kids.
Oh.
Not just yet.
I know what's going to happen. Da, 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 da.
Why don't you tell us, Faith Man?
I hear he's going to sing a song.
He don't sing.
He don't?
He got you fooled.
I think there's going to be an action song, boys and girls, so get ready. Get up on your feet and get ready for this awesome action song.
I gotta go get ready. See you later.
Yep, here he comes. All right, now all you guys have to do is you have to yell really, really loud so Handy Dandy will come out here and start the song. Hang on, I'll go find him. You guys be good. All right, bye.
Got the pavement glistening, touchdowns. I fall into your arms, right where I belong, your everlasting arms. And where would I be without you?
Here we go!
I'd be packing my bag when I need to stay. I'd be chasing every breeze that blows my way. I'd be building my kingdom just to watch it fade away.
Today, we're going to talk about something really, 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 really good. Okay, I want to know this. How many of you have your Holly Bible? Yeah, you know, the Word of God. We've got to make sure that we always have our Bible with us. Because I want to talk to you about something that it tells us in the book of Ephesians. Now, the book of Ephesians tells us about the armor of God. How many of you know about the armor of God? Yeah. Right, so that's what we're going to talk about. There are so many parts of the armor of God, but the Bible says that we need to put on the armor so that it will protect us from the wiles of the devil. I've been saying, does anybody know what that word means? Wiles? It's spelled W-I-L-E-S. Wiles. What does that mean, Handy Dandy? I don't even know what that means. You're talking big words. No, the wiles of the devil. Now, have you ever seen the cartoon with the Roadrunner and the coyote, and the coyote's chasing the Roadrunner? You know what that coyote's name is? His name was Wiley. Get that? Wiley Coyote, because he was always giving that Roadrunner fits. Well, because he was the bad guy, Wiley Coyote. So what we have to do is we have to put on the armor of God so that we can withstand that devil. Okay? So today, we're going to talk about just one part of the armor of God. Now, do you know any parts of the armor of God? Yeah? There we go. Yep. Good job. There's the helmet of salvation, the breastplate of righteousness, the shield, and we have to have on our shoes. Yeah, we got to have our gospel shoes on, and we also have to have what? Our loins girded with truth, right? So, but today we're going to just talk about one piece of that armor. We're going to talk about the helmet. Yeah. So let me go get my lesson. It's over here on my table. And as you can see, I have it right here, and it's all covered up. Yeah, right here. This is going to be fun. Check this out. On my table, I have something really, really super-duper cool, because we're going to talk about the helmet of salvation. Ooh, I want that. I heard that. Somebody said, ooh, I want that. Every time you hear Handy Dandy say, salvation. Now, check this out. This is our head. And today, I think we need a checkup from the neck up. So we're going to talk about how sin can enter into our body from here up. Do you know I can think of at least five ways from here to here, right here in this little square, right here. See that? I can think of five ways that sin can enter our body. Can you name one? Yeah. Right, through your ears. Did you know sin can enter your body through your ears? By the music that you listen to? Or if somebody's at school and they're telling you secrets that you shouldn't hear, that's called gossiping, and those things enter into your ears. We don't want those things to enter our ears, because that is sin. Get down, devil. Every time I say sin, you're supposed to do that. Say, get down, devil, stomp your foot. Okay, so what's another way that sin can enter our body from here to here? Right, through these things. These are your eyes. By the things that you watch, you know, if you watch things that you shouldn't be watching, you know, or if you read books that you should not be reading, your eyes are causing things to get into your life. Okay, now, what's another way? Right, through your mouth. Oh, you can allow sin to enter into your life through your mouth by drinking alcohol or taking drugs. And boys and girls, that is sin. And when you allow sin into your heart, bad things, you know, can happen. We're going to get into that just a little bit later. What's another way? From your ears, your eyes, your mouth. Okay, now name another one. Yes, exactly. Sin can enter through your nose. You're like, what? How can sin enter my nose? Because you reach your finger in there and you get those little... Never mind. We don't want those things in our nose. No, but there's actually people that do drugs and they sniff inhalants and things that are bad for you, and they could cause you to have brain damage. So yeah, sin can enter through your nose. Okay, so we talked about the eyes, we talked about the ears, we talked about the mouth, and we talked about the nose, but what's the fifth way that sin can enter into your life from your neck up? I gotta think about that for a minute. Wait. That's it. Through your thoughts. Think. If you're thinking bad thoughts, you know you've already sinned already. If you think about hurting somebody, or if you think about doing drugs, or if you just think about stealing something, the Bible says you've already did it in your heart, and that is sin. So we have to protect our thoughts. That's why, boys and girls, we have to put on the helmet of salvation. Ooh, I want that. So today, check out what I got here. This is really, really cool. So what if we begin to allow things into our life? What if we start to do things that we should not do. Well, Dad's not here. He told me I can't watch this show, but you know what? He's never going to find out. So all of a sudden, one of those fiery darts of the enemy start pressing. Oh, I got away with it. I did. I got away with it this time. So we think, oh, since we got away with it, maybe we can do something else that Dad don't know about. So we go in and we get that music that Dad said we can't listen to, and we decide, oh, I'm going to listen to that one song, that one that goes, and we start listening to that song, and all of a sudden, it starts saying dirty words. Uh-oh. We've allowed more things to put pressure on our life. And these things are weighing on us. They start to weigh really, really heavy. But we got away with it this time. Nothing happened. Dad didn't find out. So maybe we can do it again. Okay, so this time we decide, you know what? I am going to go and I am going to read that book that Dad said I couldn't read. He said not to read it. He said stay away from it, but I'm going to read it anyway. And so Dad's not here, so guess what we do? Here we go. We start allowing things in our life. Man, we got away with it. That's good. And Dad didn't find out, so it's okay as long as Dad don't find out. But what if somebody's at school? And peer pressure, how many of you know what that word is? Peer pressure. Oh, come on, Billy, you can do this just one time. It's just a little bitty pill. Why don't you take this pill, just put it in your mouth and swallow it. It'll make you feel good. And nobody will ever know you took it. And so you're like, peer pressure, it gets to you. And all of a sudden you take that pill and you pop it in your mouth and uh-oh. We did it. Nobody knows. We did it, and we got away with it. And so eventually we continue to do this, and we continue to live in sin. We continue to read the things we shouldn't read. We continue to watch the things we shouldn't watch. We continue to listen to the music that we shouldn't listen to. And we're allowing these things every day to apply pressure to our life. And every time we do it, it's messing with our mind. Boys and girls, and if you keep doing this over and over and over again, one day, you're going to do it. And your mind is just going to explode. You're going to go off on somebody. You're going to go to school, and all that pressure has built up in your heart. Because what you do from your neck to your head affects another part of your body. It affects your heart. And when your heart is hurting, you will tend to do things that you shouldn't do. And you will allow things into your life. And then you'll go to school and you'll be a bully and you'll be mean. So boys and girls, today we've been talking about the pressures of sin and allowing those things in your life. Now the Bible tells us that we can enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season. He'll allow that. But then all of a sudden, things are going to happen. So today I want to give you an opportunity right there where you're sitting in your house. I want you to just close your eyes. When we do that, guess what? It keeps us from seeing those things that we shouldn't be looking at. Now, I want you to get your mind focused on Jesus. Stop focusing on other things. I want you to think good thoughts. Think on the pleasures of life, the joys and everything that are virtuous in this life. And think good thoughts. And I want you to open your mouth and I want you to just start repenting. Jesus, I'm so sorry for all of my sin. I'm sorry for the bad choices that I made. I'm sorry for allowing that stuff into my life. I want you to create in me a clean heart, renew in me a right mind and a right spirit. God, I need the Holy Ghost living inside of me. So right there where you're sitting, just close your eyes, raise your hands, raise your face, and let's repent. Jesus, forgive me of my sin. I love you so much. Now let me tell you what's going to happen. When you start repenting and asking Jesus to forgive you of all your sin, guess what? He's going to start squeezing your heart. Now boys and girls, when Jesus squeezes your heart, juice is going to come out of your eyes. It's not going to hurt. It's actually going to feel really good because those sins are going to be released. And when all those sins go away, Jesus is going to get right here into your heart, and he's going to download a brand new language onto the hard drive of your heart. The big people call this part speaking in other tongues, but to me, it just sounds like silly words. So while you're sitting there praying, if your tongue starts to feel really weird and you start to speak silly words, good, because that's you being filled with the Holy Ghost. So just continue to pray. Just close your eyes, raise your hands, and raise your face. Jesus, I love you so much. Thank you for allowing me to be here. Thank you for allowing me to get my sins washed away. Just continue to pray right there where you are. Thank you guys for being here. Thank you for watching. Now, just because this video is going to end, that don't mean you have to stop praying. Wherever you are right now, I want you to continue to pray. Somebody that is with you in the room right now can lay hands on you and they can pray with you. Just remember this, that Jesus loves you and Handy Dandy and Sunflower love you. Thank you guys for watching. We love you guys.